got back and I thought, why? What's the difference? And she said, there are two reasons. She said, one was confidence and two was skill. Now, I thought about this and she's completely right. Because one, if you've got confidence and you know this should work, you'll keep trying till it does. But if you don't have the right handling skills, you will never succeed. So she fine-tuned her handling skills and she tried harder to be successful. And another wonderful thing about confidence, you get patient compliance. And I remember years ago, we had a big company in Wellington, and the posh people. And this woman always came to me in my crummy old building, and I remember saying to her, why do you come to me? And she just said, you treat me with confidence. And I didn't have the techniques I have today. But this girl went back and she had confidence, and she emailed me again 2 weeks later. She said, Brian, I think my success rate might be better than yours. And now I go off to America, and I was with Mark Steptoe, who runs these courses on pelvic pain. And if you haven't heard of Mark, you've got to. He's a genius. And in this, we have enormous numbers. So I said to the class, I said, can I meet all the CMPs, please, when we have our first break? And so they gathered, and I said to them, be honest. I said, what's your success rate with our techniques? And they said, 30 or 40%. Now, if four people coming to see you, it doesn't matter, with a musculoskeletal condition, and they can walk without pain just by using what we have to offer, they were happy. And I said, well, that's not good enough. And you probably have a similar success rate. You mightn't have a success rate as I would have, but you will after today. And there's a little bit of fiddling around to start off with, and this is where the weaknesses are. I've got some new stuff, and necessity is the mother of invention. I've got something new for the cervical spine, which involves the atlas and the occiput and the C1 and C2. And that came about because my teacher that I was teaching with fell out of a tree and injured his neck, and he turns up in America and he was terrible. He felt ill and he was giddy. And I said, oh, Mark, I'll fix you. And I remember having a go at him, and I used my AA techniques and nothing happened. And I thought, what the hell, I've done nothing. And I didn't sleep that night. I spent all night thinking about him. And I came up with a new idea because I had to. And I remember the next day trying it for the first time. And as I did it, his face changed. It just lit up. And he said, Brian, that's it. And it fixed him. So I'll show you that. And you'll use it from today on. And another area which is important is here. Because years ago, low back pain was a condition we had to deal with. But now it's here because of computers and cell phones. Everybody's like this all day. Mm-hmm. And joints hate being kept at end range. And if you go to sleep, and you've got your wrist like that, you'll wake up with a sore wrist. And if you go to bed on your tummy, well, you're going to end up with neck problems. Because you're all night like this. Hell, that's stupid. And anyway, that's just another issue.